All right, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over different methods for how you can solve for the column level security. Boom! Shakalaka, shakalaka, shakalaka. Boom, shakalaka. All right, so in analysis services Power BI, you have row level security and you have object level security. Both of these work really good. But what do you do when you encounter a situation where you need to have a column that is secured, or you need to have a measure that is secured? Row level security and column level security don't innately and inherently address those. So how do you manage that? Well, there's a couple of different ways that we can solve that. And today we're going to be going over how you can solve that challenge in column level security with direct query and true encryption. So we're going to head down to my desktop and I'm going to show this to you guys. All right. So I put together this little demo here to show you how you can get to this point where you have, normally if you come into a model, you would see information like on birth date. And birth date's one of those type of fields that there's a lot of security and scrutiny that goes around it, right? Not everyone should be able to see who's, how old someone is and, therefore when their birthday is. This is considered, privileged information. Some people in HR need to have access to that for a variety of different reasons, like knowing about upcoming retirements or pension planning, that type of a thing. But generally speaking, this information is not broadly available, and so it has to be locked down, right? What you can do with column level security, going over to direct query, what you can do is you can lock down that solution in the source so that either that column is encrypted, and then the results that get returned based upon user's access is either, potentially gobbledygook or nothing, or in this case, it's defaulting to a date. So what I've done is I've created inside my model, I've created a dimensional field here, the dim employee RLS. If I go and I look at it inside of my model, I can see the dim, or here's my DQ section. I've got my dim employee RLS table. This is defined as a direct query against my data source. You can see it here. It's labeled as direct query and it goes against the SQL Server database. Now I can go out to my SQL Server. Went out to my SQL. And I can go and I can take a look at this information and I can go in and I can look at my objects, databases, AdventureWorks. And now this is going to a view, going to my RLS view. So I'm going to script this view, create it to a new window so we can hone in and take a look. There's a lot of different ways to create this effect. I'm doing one in which I'm using the username, and then basically where it has, when it gets that value, it passes back that there's no access to the database, right? So when my name comes through and shows up, I'm not allowed to have access to that information. Otherwise, people do have access. Now I can change this up so that when I do come through, and I can actually change this to an alter. So change that guy up. Now I can pop back over to my report and I can take a look at this. Now, what I end up having to do in order to make this work is you have to get that direct query to recache itself. Aha. Now you see when I picked on Carson, that row level security and that cache kicked back in, and I was able, you could now see that data comes back, right? By default, I'm not getting the full cache in here, so it's working a little different here, but you could see that now I have access to this information. If there's a way to transform and reload just a table, you can't, right? So I gotta go back into my view. I want to unset that, that I continue to get no values on there, right? So when that's set up, I then can go back here and I can select it and it's still showing it now goes back to showing the date and time of the information that I, you know, I no longer have access to that. It defaults to that, the current date and time, which is in my query. You can also use encrypted fields here, so that when it pulls back, it's just gobbledygook for your users. It just, you know, it's just whatever. That's fine for a string. A string can come through as that gobbledygook. But if you have something like a date field where you want to retain that date date data type, you have to do what I did here, which is basically that trick of, you know, confirming that the user has access. And if the user has access in the employee table, then you provide them access to that information. Otherwise, you know, you don't, right? You give them that default value. By having that exact data type as that birth date, that allows it to go into my tabular model without causing me problems. You try to change up between having an encrypted text versus a date, you know, and go back and forth, that's just not going to work for you. It's not going to run in your view. It's not going to run inside of analysis services. This is a great solution to be able to provide that type of information. Again, over here, I have no security. Here, I do have security. So there's some pros and cons with this, right? This is true encryption. This is true security. So if you are sharing stuff broadly across your organization, or you're sharing stuff outside of your company, you know, people are able to hit this information, you know, like you have an embedded report that's sharing information outside of your organization. This allows for true security so that you can be assured that people are not seeing information that they shouldn't see. Right? This is super great for dimensions. It works really well in the situations where you have that DQ capabilities. Now, keep in mind, you know, you're going to have to make sure it's performant. But generally speaking, this is good. It allows for self-service. Like, you know, you can give out this as a data set to a group of RBI developers so that they can use that in their reports. They can build a report. They can share that report. And you can be assured that that end user who's getting this information, you know, even if that report builder who built the report had access to all that information, they could share that out to another user. And if that user didn't have access to this information, they wouldn't see it. Okay. Now, there are limitations with this, right? So, you know, it does have to be a direct query. So that means your model has to be performant. There's only certain, you know, data sources you can have, that allow for direct query. You have to be very careful around the performance of getting that model, tuning it, making sure that that table is always available, even in refreshes. All that type of thing is very important. Direct query and facts are a real challenge, right? Like, performance there is an issue. It's hard to get that to work right. So, you know, you have to like avoid this on facts. It creates some real challenges when it comes to DQ and direct query, so that, or on DAX, you know, statements. There are limitations that you can do around DAX statements, and then that user has to be granted read access into that backend database. So whatever's coming in is going to need to be able to have access to that backend service. You know, these are just some of the things that you have to keep in mind when you're designing this solution. Okay, so that's one of five column level security options that you have available for you. That is the direct query model. In the next lesson, we're going to be going over how you can achieve this for fact tables in a secure fashion. We're going to run over options with object level security, and then we will also hit on in the follow-on video how you can use a multiplier to easily add in column level security on your measures as well. So I hope you found this helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Remember, like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below, share it to your friends and family. It really helps me out. I appreciate it. You have a great day. Peace.